Byron were engaged over the summer, with Geely confirming the news in October 2015 while appearing on an episode of Tyra Banks' Fab Life. Geely said at the time, "I think if you do get involved at your workplace, you have to know that this is something that you want to be invested in, and this is just not something that is frivolous and fleeting." On Empire, Geely portrays Anika Calhoun, the former fiance to Terrence Howard's character Lucius Lyon, while Byers plays Lyon's son Andre. Gio Benitez tied the knot with Tommy Daddario on Sunday. The 30-year-old ABC News correspondent confirmed the news on social media after announcing his wedding to Daddario in Sunday's edition of the New York Times. He wrote on Instagram, "What an incredible special night saying I do to at Tommy Daddario. Thank you to our family and friends who made it so spectacular." Benitez married Daddario at the historic Walton House outside Miami, Florida, with Daddario's sister Meg officiating. Daddario is a 30-year-old social media strategist who is also models and acts. Benitez told People magazine, "It's so special to see how exciting our friends and family have been about this wedding. It is truly a celebration of love, our own, and what love means in their own lives. We're so humbled to celebrate together." Daddario added, "The support and love our family and friends have shown throughout this journey have made the entire experience that much more special." Benitez wed Daddario in front of 160 family members and friends in the Walton House's Tropical Gardens. Grooms both wore J. Crew tux and custom David Finn ties, with Benitez in navy and Daddario in chambray. Former Good Morning America weather anchor Sam Champion and Fox News Shepard Smith reporting host Shepard Smith were among the guests in attendance. Benitez joined ABC News in 2013 and appears on Good Morning America and Nightline. Kourtney Kardashian is celebrating her 37th birthday in snowy Iceland. The reality star, who turned 37 on Monday, April 18th, arrived in the country with sister Kim Kardashian and brother-in-law Kanye West on Sunday and will depart Wednesday, April 20th, according to the Iceland Monitor. Sources told the website the trio are visiting so West can record a music video for his latest album, The Life of Pablo. Kourtney and Kim shared a number of posts on social media, including a group photo in front of an icy waterfall. Kim captioned a throwback photo with her sister, "Happy birthday at Kourtney Kardashian. Thank you for always doing everything first so I can copy you. I don't know what I would do without you. I love you. Happy birthday." Kourtney also received birthday messages from mom Kris Jenner and sister Khloe Kardashian. Ex-partner Scott Disick didn't offer any public well wishes, but was spotted with Kourtney's half-sister Kendall and Kylie Jenner at Coachella over the weekend. Khloe wrote, "Happy birthday at Kourtney Kardashian. What would our family do without you? This picture sums us up. Even though I'm covered in chicken pox, you're still chilling by my side. I love you." Kourtney and Scott, who share a 6-year-old son Mason, 3-year-old daughter Penelope, and 16-month-old son Rain, split in July after 9 years of dating. The reality star revealed she's open to a possible reconciliation last week on the Today Show. Kourtney said, "We're not getting back together right now, but I don't know what the future holds in life and God's plans. But we're just doing our best to be the best parents." Scott admitted he would love to see himself and Kourtney reconcile on Sunday's episode of I Am Kate. Kourtney and her family return on Keeping Up with the Kardashians season 12 on May 1st. Clark Gregg channels Britney Spears, in a newly released preview clip for an upcoming episode of Spike's hit music competition series Lip Sync Battle. The video released Monday features the actor dressed in Spears' iconic blue and silver flight attendant uniform as seen in the pop star's music video from the hit 2003 single. Joined on stage by a group of similarly dressed dancers, Gregg is seen strutting his way across a stage airplane, trying his best to replicate Spears' dance moves and hip thrusts. The Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. star is set to compete against fellow Marvel television star Haley Atwell from Agent Carter. The dupe have been competing against each other using the music app Dub Smash since last year's Comic-Con. Gregg and Atwell will face off on Lip Sync Battle April 21st on Spike TV. Gwen Stefani will be hitting the road once again for her This Is What The Truth Feels Like summer tour. The concert series revealed Monday will feature rapper Eve as the opening act and begin July 12th in Mansfield, Massachusetts, before concluding October 15th in Los Angeles, California. An official press release for the tour says Gwen's highly anticipated tour will bring high-energy performances to dozens of cities throughout North America, including Chicago, Dallas, Detroit, Tampa, and Vancouver this summer, as well as dates in Los Angeles and San Francisco this fall. Tickets go on sale April 22nd. Eve and Stefani have collaborated before on two chart-topping hits, 2001's Let Me Blow Your Mind and 2004's Rich Girl. Stefani last made headlines in February when she performed the first ever live music video for her single Make Me Like You during the 58th Annual Grammy Awards. Fans of Pearl Jam and rock legends Boston Down in North Carolina are out of luck if they want to see them live anytime soon. Both bands have canceled their upcoming shows in the southern state in protest of the controversial bill HB2, which is considered to be anti-LGBT law. Grunt Grates Pearl Jam wrote in a handwritten statement posted on the band's Facebook page, "The HB2 law that was recently passed is a despicable piece of legislation that encourages discrimination against an entire group of American citizens." Pearl Jam had been scheduled to perform in the state capital of Raleigh on Wednesday, while Boston were meant to visit North Carolina for 3 shows next month. They join a growing number of groups and individuals boycotting North Carolina since the passage of the bill, which is officially known as the Public Facilities Privacy and Security Act. Bruce Springsteen and Ringo Starr have pulled the plug on scheduled performances in the state. Porn site Hamster has banned North Carolina residents from accessing the site, and Cirque du Soleil announced on Friday it has decided to cancel its upcoming shows in Greensboro, Charlotte, and Raleigh. Calling the legislation, quote, "an important regression to ensure human rights for all," Cirque du Soleil said in a statement. Cirque du Soleil says, "Cirque du Soleil believes in equality for all. It's a principle that guides us with both our employees and our customers. We behave as change agents to reach our ultimate goal of making a better world with our actions and our productions." Meanwhile, Greg Allman and Jimmy Buffett are not ditching their shows in the Tar Heel State despite supporting LGBT rights, and the NBA still plans to keep up the 2017 All-Star Game in Charlotte next February. Ariana Grande released the song Let Me Love You featuring Lil Wayne on Monday. The 22-year-old singer announced the track on social media, confirming the song appears on her forthcoming 3rd studio album, Dangerous Woman. Let Me Love You is one of 4 duets to appear on Grande's new record. The singer also collaborated with Nicki Minaj feature and Macy Gray and released the album's lead single, Dangerous Woman, in March. The star told AMP Radio the same month, "I'm starting putting out music when I was 16 or 17, and now I'm 22 now. I know that it's a little bit of time in the grand scheme of things, but a lot has happened in those few years." She also added the new record, "I feel I've grown so much, I've learned so much, and have personally evolved, so I wanted my sound to evolve as well. I feel like that growth is representing this body of work." Star revealed, "It's darker, it's more mature. It's a very nice blend between the R&B stuff that I've done in the past and the pop stuff that I've done in the past, but it definitely has my flavor, but it's definitely the next phase as well." Grande unveiled the Dangerous Woman track list Saturday ahead of the album's release May 20th. Singer last released the holiday record Christmas and Chill in December, which peaked at number 34 on the Billboard 200 albums charts. Taylor Swift continues to promote Apple Music in a new ad that features the singer jamming out to Jimmy Eat World's The Middle. Swift says in the clip posted on Twitter Monday, "Oh my gosh, I love this song. I used to listen to this in middle school." The ad features Swift playing the 2001 hit rock song as she gets ready for a night out. Highlighting Apple's Music streamlined mobile and playlist feature, the Shake It Off singer selects The Middle and then proceeds to play air guitar and sing into her red lipstick as she lip syncs the song's lyrics. The video comes weeks after Swift's first Apple Music ad, which featured the pop star singing along to Drake and Future's hip-hop hit Jumpman before crashing on a treadmill. Recently, Swift spoke about her relationship with boyfriend Calvin Harris in the latest issue of Vogue magazine, stating, "I'm just taking things as they come." Rihanna and Leonardo DiCaprio were spotted together recently during the Coachella Valley Music and Arts Festival. The singer and Academy Award winner were seen by concertgoers Saturday during Coachella's Neon Carnival, according to Us Weekly. Rihanna and DiCaprio attempted to stay incognito during their meetup, with the actor wearing a baseball cap and dark shades. Rihanna wore a pair of oversized gold sunglasses. During the event, DiCaprio reportedly was seen whispering into Rihanna's ear, eliciting a couple of smiles. The duo have been linked together since January of 2015 after being spotted partying together at various celebrity gatherings. On Sunday, Rihanna took the stage during Coachella for a surprise performance alongside Calvin Harris for their 2011 hit We Found Love. Harris was also joined by Big Sean and John Newman during his set, but not by his girlfriend Taylor Swift, who was rumored to make an appearance alongside the DJ. Rihanna recently made the news for landing a deal to start up her own makeup line, Fenty Beauty by Rihanna. And let's take a look at what happened on this date in entertainment history. On this date in 2002, My Big Fat Greek Wedding was released. As a struggling actress in Hollywood in the early 1990s, Nia Vardalos had been told to hide the fact that she was of Greek heritage, or to pretend that she was Italian in order to get film roles. Frustrated, she decided to write her own movie to star in based on her experiences growing up in a huge Greek-Canadian family. The result, My Big Fat Greek Wedding, was released on this date in 2002. Born on September 24th in 1962 and raised in Winnipeg, Ontario, Vardalos started acting in high school. She later joined Chicago's Second City comedy troupe, where she met fellow comic Ian Gomez. They married in 1993 after Gomez was baptized Greek Orthodox, an experience that Vardalos wrote into the movie for her on-screen love interest played by John Corbett. According to an interview with Vardalos later published in Red Book, her career stalled after the couple moved to Los Angeles, where Gomez got roles on The Drew Carey Show and Felicity. When she began shopping her screenplay around, Hollywood executives wanted to cast a name actress such as the Italian-American Marissa Tomei or the Puerto Rican-American Jennifer Lopez in the lead role, a change that Vardalos refused to accommodate. While performing a well-reviewed one-woman comedy show in Los Angeles, Vardalos impressed one particular audience member, the actress Rita Wilson, who happened to be of Greek heritage and married to one of America's favorite leading men, Tom Hanks. With Hanks and Wilson signed on as producers, My Big Fat Greek Wedding was on its way. Filmed on a budget of $5 million, the movie told the story of a 30-year-old ugly duckling, Vardalos, working as a waitress in her family's restaurant, who finally attracts the man of her dreams, a waspy teacher played by Corbett, and is faced with the bigger challenge of introducing him to her overprotective family. From a limited release on April 19th, buzz for My Big Fat Greek Wedding grew steadily through word of mouth, and the film began earning more and more each week. It would eventually rake in some $240 million at the box office, becoming one of the most profitable movies of all time based on its budget-earning ratio. My Big Fat Greek Wedding received generally positive reviews, although some critics saw the humor as more suited for a television sitcom than a big-screen comedy. The overwhelmingly enthusiastic reaction of audiences spoke for itself. However, at the Academy Awards in 2003, Vardalos received an Academy Award nomination for Best Original Screenplay. The CBS network greenlit a sitcom spin-off by Big Fat Greek Life, which all the original cast members except Corbett, who had a conflict, signed on for. With Vardalos, Hanks, and Wilson as executive producers, the series debuted in February 2003, but was canceled after only 7 episodes. And that is your entertainment report for Tuesday, April 19th, 2016. I'm your host, Mr. Downtown Ray Mello. I'll be back tomorrow to deliver some major stories and trends going on in the world of entertainment and beyond. You can follow the show on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram, facebook.com/TheEntertainmentReport with Ray Mello, that's R-A-Y-M-E-L-O, on Twitter at The Enter Report, or on Instagram at The Entertainment Report. You can listen to this episode or any previous episodes of The Entertainment Report anytime you want on iHeartRadio. Just go to iHeart.com or your iHeart phone app, search for The Entertainment Report, and it'll take you to the page. Good night, and God bless you all.